Hi, I'm Janek Gwizdala. Welcome to free video number 2. We are talking about left and right hand technique. In the last video, I kind of wanted you to get that elbow, accentuate that elbow, get that thing up in the air and get away from having the wrist bent if that was a habit you were in. And even if that wasn't a habit you were in, you know, I just want to instill these kind of, not even the specifics, but just the process of being conscious of all these small moving parts that make up the bigger picture of being a bass player, of being a musician in general. So as I promised, this week we're going to take a look at the left hand. I've got another exercise for you. Download it, just click the PDF below the video and download that. I'm going to play it for you. I'm going to play it pretty slow so you can hear it. I'm a huge fan when it comes to practice routine, and practice routine is something we're going to talk a lot about in the course, in the 12-week course that starts in a few days. We're going to talk a lot about practice routines and how to structure your practice routine and just tons of things. I can't even get into it right now. But one of the things I'm a huge fan of is doing more than one thing at the same time. Now, it came to my attention when I first started practicing the bass and playing the bass. I was playing all these kind of, you know, scales and arpeggios and all these exercises. And for the most part, they were all ascending. They went up the instrument. Just going up and up and up and up and up, and I never did the descending counterpart for whatever reason. So this kind of like a bing light bulb went on, and I was like, okay, I really need to work on some descending aspects of just basic music and basic harmony. So I have a descending major scale pattern exercise for you, which is great. It's great for both hands. It's great for the entire instrument. Now, what I want you to concentrate on, in fact, you know what, take a listen to it. It sounds like this. So important to hear these things first. Not even to get bogged down in the notes or the technicality, but just hear it a few times. Again, pause and rewind. I don't want to play it over and over and over again for you, because you can just pause and rewind. We can get more information in a short video. So this is the descending exercise, and it's in the key of C. And I'll play it up to speed, and we'll take it apart, and we'll break it down, and we'll get to this left hand stuff in just a second. Sounds something like this. Okay. Harmonically, very simple. Every note in there is in the key of C major, and it's basically a four-note cells, if you like, descending through the key of C. And it starts on a G. Again, you can download the music below this video and check it out at your own pace. So basically, what I'm trying to be conscious of, and I was trying to be conscious of it so much that I played a wrong note there, but I'm really thinking about this whole left hand moving as a unit. This kind of a triangle pattern between the pinky finger, the first finger, and the thumb. So the thumb, if I turn my bass over here so that you can see this, if I turn it on its side, the thumb is in the center between the first finger and the pinky finger. The thumb's in the center to give the most support, and the entire hand moves as a unit. So these are definitely fundamental and basic things, and I know a lot of you are saying, well, yeah, okay, I kind of know that. But I guarantee you, if you take this exercise or any musical example, and really scrutinize yourself, put it under the microscope, practice slowly, you're gonna find, because I know this, I have great technique and I do this all the time and have to correct myself. You're going to find the fingers move and the thumb stays behind, which is a drag, because then this pinky finger over here has no support from the thumb, which is left all the way down the neck. So again, finger per fret, we're starting with this G natural. And there's only one shift in this exercise, and that's why I chose it, because it only happens one time, and you know, there aren't tons of shifts where your thumb's easily going to get left behind. And this is a great one for putting that shifting idea in the muscle memory, just making sure your whole hand shifts down the instrument. Because when you start to get into, when you start getting into more complex and linear ideas like that have lots of shifts in them, that's gonna be key to really being able to produce a good tone with every note that you play. When you're going from this note to this note down here, when you're shifting three octaves like that, you want to have the ability. You might not necessarily want to play every note the same, that might be unmusical, but you wanna have the ability to produce a multitude of different sounds on any note that you're playing at any given time on the neck. So this whole shifting thing was a huge part of what makes my playing so fluid and what I think can really help your playing as well. So I would take that exercise super slowly. And just make sure, I would even repeat the first few times just to keep going over that shift. Of course, play it in a bunch of different keys. You know, move it all the way around the neck. You're also going to find, of course, the frets are further apart. They're wider down here in the lower end of the instrument. It's more of a stretch with the left hand. Using finger per fret is a little more strenuous on the left hand. And then, even though now you get a bit of a rest with the frets being closer together up here, but then the string is further away from the neck, depending on how you have your bass set up, of course. But generally, the string is further away from the neck, so you have to push in more and use a little more pressure to get a sound higher up. So you're kind of making this transition through the neck of it being kind of wide and not having to push down so much here, getting narrower and having to push down on the strings the further up you go. So a key element of my practice routine was always to use the entire length of the neck. That was always so important for me. I kind of did it without knowing. It wasn't like I was told that or I had some genius idea. I just kind of played the bass. I just played all of the instrument and it definitely paid off. And now when I go back and look at that, I can say, aha, this was really important. And I want you to be conscious of that as well. I want that to help you and your practice routine and help your ability to play better and to have more consistency with your sound throughout the entire instrument. So we've taken a quick look at the right hand and a little bit of a look at the left hand. You've already got two exercises which have been kind of huge for me. They seem really simple and they may seem, okay, this is like some beginner stuff, but I still use those things today. Like before I started filming this video, I was using actually not the two we've talked about already. I was actually using the one we're gonna look at in the next lesson. It's slightly more complicated. It involves two different tonalities instead of just the one. But these are all ideas that I used when I started 17 years ago and I still use to warm up, to go through my practice routine. If you're short on, this is another big thing as well. If you're short on time, you don't have a long time to practice, it's nice to have a few ideas like this that you can say, okay, I've got 15 minutes. I'm gonna work on those things and I'm gonna be conscious of where the right hand is, where the left hand is, how relaxed I am, my posture, and all of these things, and just have a nice little practice routine put together. And as we add these ideas, as we add these PDFs, don't forget to download the PDFs below the video. I can't stress that enough. This is all free for you. You should make use of it. And the more of those things you add together, you won't need to even refer to the PDFs anymore. They'll just be a part of your vocabulary, your practice vocabulary, and you'll be able to draw upon them no matter how long or how short a practice time you have. So check it out. We'll look at this kind of bigger idea in video 3. It's coming up in a couple of days. It's going to look at a couple of different tonalities and a couple of different techniques with the left hand in terms of changing shape and more kind of detailed shifting, which, you know, we don't always play our entire lives. So to kind of expand our ability, to expand our vocabulary, to expand our fluidity, we are going to look at some slightly more involved examples and involved exercises. So we'll check that out in part 3. I'm Janek Gwizdala, it's videobasedlessons.tv, and we'll see you on the next lesson.